Lance Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside. We're ready to go with another big special day on Championship Wrestling. Good morning, David.
Good morning. Yeah, you're right. We've got a special day coming up here. We've got, for one thing, we've got some great matches coming up. Six-man tag team action. We'll have Bruno and Boy Tony in here. And Boy Tony is going to be in the ring with Bubba and Goliath. Should be an interesting six-man match.
Yeah.
And, of course, with Bruno in the corner, downtown Bruno, that's always interesting, to say the least.
Uh-huh.
Jeff Jarrett, Billy Travis are going to be along in a tag team match. John Paul will be going against the Hunter. We'll have Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka also teamed up in the Expiration of Time main event tag team match today.
Yeah, boy, and that isn't all. I'll tell you what else we're going to try to do. This for the first time. We're going to try to get the King on the phone to hear from him since the argument that the injury, rather, that he had said argument. I'm thinking, boy, it was a whole lot worse than any kind of an argument on that. We're going to try to get the King on the phone. And for a lot of the folks, by the way, I started out saying good morning. I realize this is not morning in a lot of places. will you? That's okay. We're a little excited because I think some of the folks around here know that this celebrates the 20th anniversary that Dave and I have been working together on Championship Wrestling, and we are both delighted. Thank you very much. We really, really have been blessed with a lot of wonderful wrestling fans and a lot of wonderful wrestling talent, too. We look back into the past, and it kind of gives us a kick when we stop and think of some of the guys we know and some of the pictures that we're taking.
Here's one right here. This was not 20 years ago. This was 17 years ago. Now, in the early days, occasionally you'd have the match was a little bit boring.
I was going to say, you look like a little bored there.
I would have felt bad about this, but, you know, even though Lance was doing the commentary, occasionally he'd nod off, too, back in those days. But that's 17 years ago, December 1969.
That's how we've lasted 20 years. We each take turns going to sleep while the other one's working.
Most of them, of course, much more exciting than that,
boy,
I guarantee.
Boy, you got that for a living fact. And we've got some of those lined up today. We, I am sure, will not be able to restrain ourselves for making references to it throughout the entire day. Right now, though, we're going to get ready for that opening bout. We've got a good one coming up, a six-man tag match. We'll be back to it in a moment. Years, I guess. I guess the nostalgia of it all, we can't help but be standing here doing a little talking about the 20 years and some of the guys that we have known and some of them we wish we could forget. And speaking of forgetting, maybe this would be
Hey.
Downtown Bruno and the Pittsburgh Connection.
The Downtown Connection, brother. You know what? I'm sick and tired of hearing you out here talking about, oh, we did this 20 years ago, we did that 20 years ago. Don't you understand that the wrestlers are the stars, that you and this guy would be nothing without us, that you'd be a vacuum cleaner salesman, he'd be selling used cars somewhere. Yins wouldn't be nothing. Yins guys wouldn't be nothing if it wasn't for professional wrestling. That's what it's all about. That's the bottom line. So I'm tired of hearing about it.
That all you got to say, Bruno?
Talking about the past, seeing you picture Yins guys sitting around looking like the Bobbsey twins or whatever, Frankie Lyman and the teenagers. I don't want to hear it. This is the stars, baby, the Downtown Connection, the Mighty Goliath, Big Baba, Boy Tony, and Downtown Bruno. And that's the way it is. We are the superstars, baby. Not you and not this goofball, okay? That's the way it is, Lance Russell.
Well, I'll tell you what, Bruno. We were here before you came around.
Oh, big deal.
We'll be here.
Oh, you were here.
Hey, you make a big deal about 8 years. You're 8 years.
8 years in the
business. We're talking 20 years.
Whoa! You've been here a lot longer. You've been here a lot. Big deal. Big deal. Now it's time to destroy some people. Now it's time to show you why you have a job, because it is professional wrestling. It's a Downtown Connection, baby. Oh, yeah.
That's the best place for you. Just go up there and stay right in the chair. That would be lovely. Some things never change, do they, Dave?
No, they don't. And I tell you, unfortunately, that Bruno is one of them here recently. Now, we got a six-man coming up here. This, come on, the team of Bubba, Goliath, and Boy Tony, they're heavy favorites going in. Weight alone, they weigh over 1,000 pounds. 639 is total weight on the other side. Jerry Garman, Benny Traylor, and Jim Jameson.
Will you let him get the introductions out?
Okay, okay. Well, hey, everybody knows your boy Tony, Big Bubba, and Goliath are. Who cares about these other goofballs? I mean, come on, this guy's going to be hit with so many rights, he's going to be begging for a left. Look at the guy. You want to talk about the two brown clowns and the yellow tights? Yellow, yeah, they're going to be running so fast, brother, they can qualify for the Olympics. Look at that. He's throwing them around like a rag doll, baby. Look at him stepping on his face. There ain't nothing that these guys can do to the Dot Connection. They do not have a prayer, Lance Russell. Did you see anything like this 20 years ago? Did you see anything like this 20 years ago?
I got to admit, I never saw anybody that big 20 years ago.
I tell you what, this is a whole new way, a brand new day, baby. We got the greatest wrestlers, the biggest wrestlers, I should say, Big Bubba and the Mighty Goliath. We got the greatest wrestler in there, boy, Tony. We got the greatest manager, Don Tom Bruno. I mean, you had some skinny geek named Jimmy Hart. Now he's a circus clown, but we won't get into that. I mean, look at boy Tony destroying this guy. I mean, look at him. Look at him with that boy Tony thumb, baby. That's patented. We get a trademark on that, brother. Downtown Connection, DTC, baby.
Well, I'll say one of the greatest contributions that I think you've made downtown to the championship wrestling program. You make me sometimes wish that Jimmy Hart was back.
Jimmy Hart? Jimmy Hart ain't nothing. Let's not even talk about Jimmy Hart. He's a goofball. Jimmy Hart sold out. Jimmy Hart sold out. He's a goofball. Don't even compare me to him. Don't even compare me to a circus clown.
Brought it up.
Hey, I paid a lot of dues to get where I'm at, and you got some skinny geek like Jimmy Hart don't mean nothing. Just like you two don't mean nothing. Sitting here, oh, 20 years, big deal, showing pictures of you two back when you had the different hair pieces, you know, with the different color hair. That don't mean nothing to me. I don't care if you've been out here for 90 years. You're still egotistical. You got a big mind. You're biased. You're always against the Dot Connection. That's the way it is. Well, brother, I'm going to put a fast stop to that because you know what? Because that's the way it has to be. It's like Mama says, it bees that way sometimes. Like my friend Jonathan Boyd likes to say, baby, but I say that's the way it has to be. Now look at this. Look at this Jameson.
Yeah,
Jameson.
Big thumb right in his throat. I'll bet you anything. I couldn't see it, but it sure looked like he caught him with a thumb.
Hey, when Boyd turns in the ring, he turns it into a death trap. That's what it is, baby, a death trap. Look at Jameson laying there like he just got ran over by a smashed up Lincoln Continental, baby. Look at him. He's pathetic. He looks like he's gonna die, baby. There's not gonna be nothing left of him. Look at this. Listen to him screaming hard for his mama. Ha! Yeah, it is that way, she say, right?
Right fist, right in the middle of the stomach of Jameson. Now they're pounding his head up on that top turnbuckle.
Ah, yeah, baby. Hey, Lance Russell, have you ever seen a downtown connection like this before? Have you ever seen a tag team like this before? Have you ever seen a three-man tag team like this before? Have you ever seen a manager like me before?
Oh, no, that's for a fact.
Ha! He frankly took his head off. Look at him laying there. I think he's dead. No. He's moving. He smells like he's dead, but hey, he smelled like he's dead before the match even started, so we won't even get into that, brother.
Right out of the ring, Goliath knocks Jim Jameson.
Well, get in the ring! Get in the ring, boy! Shut up! Look at this goofball here, Lance Russell. And why is this goofball called me a weasel? I don't like it. Do I look like a weasel? No, I look like a man.
You ask the question, you'll get the answer.
Shut up!
Goliath pounding Jameson down. Tag on boy Tony.
Boy, they're just totally overpowering Garmin Traylor and now Jameson. Just boy Tony just really hammered him down to the mat there. And you're right. He's caught him in the throat with a thumb a couple of times. Right there, he got him in the throat.
Hey, what do you think of boy Tony's new tights? Aren't they beautiful? The nice purple lavender blue tights. What do you think, Lance?
Well, I think it's nice there's a change finally in there, Bruno.
Hey, I had them sent up from Fort Duquesne Boulevard, baby. I had them sent up from a chick I knew down there walking up and down. She sent them just for boy Tony to wear.
Your colors, Bruno.
Oh, yeah, baby. Pink and purple. That's the way it is, brother. Pink and purple and red and black and downtown Bruno. That's the way it is. Look at boy Tony's beautiful new tights. They're just beautiful. The beautiful makeup, the beautiful hair. I mean, we're talking about the good, the bad, and the ugly. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I hear that.
Oh, hey, we're talking about so bad. We're talking about so mean, so ugly, and we're talking about so good all at the same time.
I was asking where the good was going to be.
The good. Good wrestlers, ugly with hatred, baby. And bad to the bone, Jack. Bad to the bone, Jack. Look at this guy. This guy couldn't get out of his own way. This guy couldn't hit the broadside of a barn with a broadside of a barn. Oh, yeah, baby.
Well, I don't think there's any question they got him. They've had him since the opening bell in there with a team that got two guys that weigh over 400 pounds. And Tony is no lightweight either. He outweighs anybody on the other team.
Look at that, Lance Russell.
Big splash.
One, two.
Okay. So there's the official bell to sound and end this one. And frankly, for the three guys on the other side of the ring, I'm kind of glad it's over.
I am too. 5 minutes, 15 seconds was the time on it. And I think Goliath, Bubba, and boy, Tony probably could have ended it earlier than that had they gone for the pin, but they didn't. 5:15, the official time.
Yep. 5:15, the official time. And the winners, Bubba, Goliath, and boy, Tony. Yes.
Lance Russell. Let me tell you something. You're out here the whole time during a match. I'm trying to commentate on it unbiasedly and fairly. I'm trying to give those other guys fair commentary, everything. All you're out here doing is talking about you and his goofballs 20 years or whatever.
We're trying to have a happy day, Bruno.
Oh, happy
it was
day. Happy day. Ha, big deal. Big deal. Lance Russell. You want to talk about a happy day? It's a happy day for me because I'm a winner. I am a winner. And I think you should show everybody just why I'm such a winner. I think you got a little bit of videotape.
Yeah, okay, we got some videotape. I may want to show it for a different reason than you. This was the boxing match Downtown Bruno had with Emily Arthur. Let's take a look at it right now. Free Jerry Calhoun trying to get her back. She just pounded him. Here comes Big Bob up on a ring apron. Emily Arthur won't leave him. Here comes Big Lou Winston in the ring. And as the referee's getting Lou out, uh-oh, Bubba. Man, he slapped it too. That's got to be. Big Bubba jumped up and hit Emily Arthur right in the midsection. Downtown Bruno swings and knocks her down. We're still some 32 seconds left in this round. She hadn't gotten up. Must be 7, 8, 9, 10, and that's going to be it. 1 minute, 11 seconds of the third round. Bruno is the winner. That was really nifty. It took a 400-pound man to knock her down, and you come out.
Hey. But I threw the knockout punch. They don't ask how you win. It's vision win. Good fight.
We are going to be taking a break, and we're going to be back in just a moment.
News for you. I'm talking about 7 outstanding matches, my friend. Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum, and brother, it is going to be some night of the World Heavyweight Championship match, the final bout, 3 title matches, including a Southern Tag Team title match, where Big Bubba and Goliath go again against Jared and Travis. You weren't able to stop them the first time. You said they were going to be easy. Right.
Hey, we find out that they cheat just a little bit better than we thought they cheated. Well, let me tell you something. Don't I look like I'm dressed for a wedding? I look like I fell off a wedding cake. Well, Jared and Travis, let me tell you something, boys. You ain't going to put no more cake on me. And maybe after we beat you up, we might just throw some pies in your face and kick you around that ring a little bit, right?
Yeah, you'll have to do it all Wednesday night. They plan on keeping those belts. There they are, and you'll see them in there Wednesday. Right now, Austin Idol has some words about the title match.
I used to think Evansville, Indiana had something going for itself. I really thought that that was kind of a special town. But you know something? When I really reflect back and I think about it, it's a nothing happening town. There's big, fat, ugly women there. The men, they have big pot bellies. They're out sitting at the bars all night. They're drinking beer. They're looking at their televisions and they're saying, why can't I be like him? Why can't I look like him? Why can't I talk like him? Why can't I walk like him? Why can't I dress like him? Why can't I wear a $3,000 Rolex watch? Well, baby, I'm just like this Rolex watch. I'm built to perfection. And Nick Bockwinkel, you come strutting down the aisle with the AWA World's Heavyweight title on your waist that Jerry the King Lawler could never get. After all the promises he made, he could never really cut the mustard when he had to. That's the difference between you and me, Lawler. When I say I'm going to do something, I do it. I can back it up, Jack. And Bockwinkel, I'm going to chew you up in Evansville. You're looking at the new champ.
Austin Idol, Nick Bockwinkel, Wednesday night in Evansville. We got a dandy of a tag team match coming up. Bruno, what in the world?
You cut me off so fast the last time I was out here, I didn't even have time to finish what I was saying. Now then, Lance Russell, I had some other videotape that I want all these goofballs, hillbillies, rednecks, and geeks to look at, and you didn't give me a chance. So roll the tape, baby. There's some other tape I want to look at.
I know where you tried to cost Jarrett and Travis a title. I know about
that. I don't want to make no accusations, and you shouldn't be. That ain't your job. 20 years, right? That ain't your job. Just show the tape.
All right, let's take a look at it right now. Texas Deathmatch, RPMs, Jarrett and Travis. And what is downtown Bruno signaling? Here comes Bubba and Goliath. Absolutely no business in the ring. No business in the ring. The RPMs with Jarrett and Travis. They whip them in to the massive bodies of Goliath and Big Bubba.
Referee has no neck. No neck.
There's a pin, and I believe it's Travis on Tommy Lane. 4 minutes, 16 seconds. Jarrett and Travis win it. Jeff Jarrett up. They are going to win it. At the 10 count and the fifth fall, so the new Southern Tag Champ, Jarrett and Travis. Goliath and Big Bubba enter the ring. The RPMs, they're pounding away on Jarrett and Travis. The RPMs. Final result, Travis and Jarrett were the winners of the match in the fifth fall. Yeah, you were the special manager of the RPMs for that match. Kind of backfired.
Well, hey. The RPMs are probably the greatest single tag team in the history of professional wrestling. I will say that because they've been around a long time. They've been a unit a long time. They are the best. But looking towards the future, the Dot Connection is on its way up. And I think we made one mistake. And as they always say, leave the people asking for more. And I don't think Jarrett and Travis want any more of the Dot Connection, baby.
Okay, Bruno. We'd appreciate it if you would make that your last appearance. I think you've been out here enough to last us for quite some time. Okay, we were telling you about tag action. We've got what ought to be a dandy coming up. We're going to be seeing the Southern Tag Champions, Jeff Jarrett and Billy Travis, in action. They've got a non-title type of match, but we'll be... Oh, hey, Guy Coffey. Yes, sir.
Lance, I just want to congratulate you and Dave on 20 years. It doesn't seem like it's been 20 years. It's been more like just a few, but we've enjoyed every one of them, and we've enjoyed having you, and I know these people love it, both of you, and we're just tickled to death that you've been here that long, and you too, Dave, and now we're going to call Randy Hale out. He has a little presentation.
Oh, well, all right. We appreciate that very much, and it's folks like you that we've had the opportunity to work with. Here comes Randy, my boy. Look at that son of a gun. Isn't that something? Hey, let's see. Can we share this with the people? Can we get it over here
a little bit, Dave?
Let's not let it slide off, but let's see, Randy, if we can get it up here where they can see it on, what, camera two? Okay, can you get a shot of that?
Isn't that absolutely beautiful?
Oh, I love it. Lance and Dave ringing the bell of success for 20 years. Thank you.
That is fantastic. First of all, I would like to thank everybody at Cecil's right here on Union Street. They decorated it, and they wanted me to tell you that they love watching you, and they gave us this cake, and they said they wish you the best ever.
Well, we appreciate them participating with it. David, I think our hair is a little darker there.
That's so true, man.
But I appreciate that thought, too.
I'd like to take a few more seconds of your time, Lance, to say that, you know, I've been around you for a long time.
We've had that pleasure.
Yes, and been around Dave. I have to speak for all the wrestling fans to say there's no doubt in my mind, no doubt in these people's mind, the best two announcers in the world today is standing right here with me, Lance Russell and Dave Bryan.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I speak on behalf of our good friend Jerry Jarrett, head of Jarrett Promotions. He wishes that he could be here today. He congratulates you on the 20 years. Also, I speak on behalf of the fans and the viewers. 20 years is a long time, but Lance, you have made, you and Dave have been a great part in the success of this television program, and sometimes we don't give you enough credit. You're great, and I think everybody agrees. And if I could get Sam Lowe, our photographer, if I could get Lance and Dave to get in the picture, if we could, Sam, if we could get a real quick picture of Lance and Dave holding that. That is fantastic. One other thing I'd like to do, like I said, Eddie was unable to be here, but I stopped by the office and got him to say a few words. So let's listen to that interview right now.
Okay.
Hi, Lance and Dave. I wished I could have been there this morning, but you know, part of my job is to get out and seek new talent. I'm on the road today, but I'm not only speaking for myself, but for Jarrett Promotion and millions of fans out there. I want to congratulate you and Dave on a super job, 20 years as a team. Magnificent tag team champions all over the world, but y'all are the champions in my book.
Oh, wasn't that great? I want to congratulate you, Dave. A fantastic job. And Lance, we love you.
Thank you very much. And Guy, we appreciate the thought on it. And I'll tell you, sometimes it's some in the middle of some of these things, it seems like 40 years, doesn't it?
Oh, come on.
Bruno, will you give us a break today?
I told you, I am sick and tired of this. I don't care if you've been here for 20 years. I don't care if you've been here for 90 years. I don't care if you've been here for 300 years. You wouldn't be nothing. You wouldn't be nothing. Nobody would be nothing if it wasn't for me and the rest of the people involved, the wrestlers, the managers, the referees. People like you don't mean nothing. You're just parasites living off of us. I'm sick and tired of it. You know, you'd be a used car salesman. You'd be a vacuum cleaner salesman.
Wait a minute. We've sat out here for 20 years. 20 years we've sat out here. We've had to put up with these weasley little managers coming out here insulting everything that we're trying to put together out here and have a good time and celebrate a little bit with the fans. And here you are. You've been out here half the show. Why don't you do us a favor? Just get out of here and leave us alone the rest of the day.
My sentiments exactly.
Do you like this cake? Yeah, I like it. Okay, come on, leave the cake alone.
Just put the cake down.
Do you like this cake?
Bruno, will you get out of that?
Sit down.
Hey, come on. Come on, listen. Don't start that stuff here.
You understand what I'm saying?
Listen, you can be replaced too. Come on, Bubba. Now, don't start with that stuff. Get out here and send. He's in there messing up our cake and all. Dave, thank you, guys. Oh, yes, get a good shot of that, by all means. Hey, he asked for it. He's the one that asked for it. Man, I hate that beautiful cake. Is messed up like that.
Well, the Cecil's people did a great job on that, and I hate to see that happen to the cake, but that's worth it right there.
Couldn't
see it all over
Bruno's. Good. Okay. Hey, come on now.
Take
get
on
him out of here. You
come
better
on.
Take him out and get him cleaned up.
good enough for him, huh?
Oh, boy. Well, we still got half of it here, but I don't know whether I'd touch it after Bruno's been around, that son of a gun. We are really sorry about... Oh, that's a shame. Such a beautiful cake. Okay, we're back to what we came here for.
Yeah,
David.
All right.
Up in the ring, Jeff Jarrett, Billy Travis, they are handing out to the guard the Southern Tag Team titles, the belts. They are not at stake in this match, but they do hold those belts at this time. On the other side of the ring, we got Tony Burton in there, along with Keith Roberson, or Roberson. Roberson out of Memphis, Tennessee, Burton out of Nashville, where he now makes his home. Jeff Jarrett, of course, out of the Nashville area. Billy Travis from Lexington, Kentucky. Tag team action. And I don't know if the fans saw it or not, but Roberson, when he came out here, there wasn't a wild animal save. He had on a leopard skin coat. He had on a mink ponytail. And has on boots, you'll notice when he gets in the ring, but they look like...
Looks like a llama.
Look like Clydesdale feet
yeah,
or something.
That's right. Perfect, Dave. Hey, you know, something we've talked about off the show, but it's amazing the physical similarity and the looks between Roberson and the Ninja, or Tony Burton.
You're right, especially with the beard and the hairstyle. They look like they look like brothers.
Yeah,
when they step
they
in.
Really do. Jeff Jarrett in with Tony Burton, and there's a tag on the aggressive youngster from Lexington, Kentucky, Billy Travis. He drops down. I've talked with Jeff and Billy. Hey, and he caught a big Tony Burton. And I mean, put him right down on the deck.
Boy, he did with that upper arm. Just nailed him right down to the mat. Stopped him in his tracks. Cover by Billy. Counts a two. But it's a two count. Tony Burton kicks out.
You know, I've talked to Jeff and Billy, and I know you have too, Dave, away from the cameras and that sort of thing. And the thing that I love about these, they're both really nice guys, but they will admit that they don't know everything. They still got a lot to learn. They make mistakes, but they're going to get in there and give it everything they've got every time. Look at that. Almost a pin on Keith Roberson, but Burton breaks it up and jumps on Travis. And look at Jeff Jarrett, not to leave his partner hanging out to dry. Right back at him. Woo! We got all four of them really swinging away at each other.
And right now, Burton and Roberson getting the advantage. Oh, look out. Here comes Goliath and Bubba jumping in there. Roberson holding up Travis. Now Goliath working on. He's got a chain. He was hammering him with a chain. Bubba with Jeff Jarrett back in the corner.
Yeah, look at the chain. Goliath has got there too. And Bubba just nailed Jeff over in the corner with the chain again and again. Here comes.
Roberson and Burton have got the door barred over there, so nobody can get in to help out Jeff
yeah.
and Billy. Bruno takes still over his face.
Oh, yeah, you think it's funny, I know.
It's fun, isn't it, Bruno?
Keith Roberson and Tony Burton holding the door so nobody can get in to help them out. And they're not letting anybody come in to help Jeff and Billy while these two 400-pound giants are in there pounding. Not pounding only, with chains. They've got Billy and Jeff both bleeding as Bubba throws the referee back and Goliath starts choking Billy Travis. They're still trying to get that door open over there.
Oh, come on, Bruno.
Oh. Bruno with two hands full of cake throwing it over at... Hey, come on.
Come on.
Bruno!
both cut open. Hey, Pat Tanaka, Paul Diamond, John Paul finally get through the door. That'll get rid of them, at least for a while. Jeff and Billy, though, both cut open. Their foreheads cut. Used those chains, just pounded him repeatedly over the eyes.
Boy, I guess. Man, I'll tell you, they end up winning it by disqualification, but that's a little consolation when you're laying there bleeding and have taken a beating that they just got through taking. Not only, as we said, just pounded on them, they both had chains beating on Jeff and Billy, and they really busted them open good. Okay. While they're administering to Jeff and Billy, we're going to take time out, and we're going to be back here in just a moment.
I'm talking about regular prices Wednesday night at the Coliseum, my friend. Yeah, we're going to be back into action in a second, but take a listen to this. Evansville Coliseum Wednesday night, 7 matches, including 3 title matches, all at regular prices. Alan West against Boy Tony, Roy Lee Welch against Tarzan Goto. Akio Sato returns, and he'll be facing Paul Diamond. Daughter of Darkness Locke will be going against Debbie Combs. International heavyweight title defense with Soul Train Jones defending against The Hunter. A Grudge Southern tag team title match when Jeff Jarrett and Billy Travis will be facing Big Bubba and Goliath, with, of course, Bruno down there at ringside. And then comes the AWA World Heavyweight Championship match when Austin Idol will be going after Nick Bockwinkel. Brother, that is going to be some kind of a night. 7 bouts in all coming up Wednesday night at the Coliseum, and all at regular prices. Stirring them up, Soul Train Jones in here for a little action match with Keith Eric. Ready for the official introduction, Dave.
All right, Keith Eric out of Memphis, Tennessee. Keith Eric is down at 216 pounds. And across the way, top hat, the belt being handed to the referee right now. That's the man out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 243 pounds, Soul Train Jones. One fall, 10-minute time limit match coming up. Jerry Calhoun is the referee. Oh, Keith Eric jumps Soul Train from behind. Keith Eric he never steps in the ring. He doesn't think he's going to really walk all over the opposition. One of his tactics we've seen him use before, he'll try to jump his opponent before the bell sounds. Yeah, so far, it's working for him. He jumps right on the throat of Soul Train Jones. There's a count of 2, but Soul Train breaks out. Here's what you better watch, Keith. If Soul Train ever does get going here, you better be ready to move.
He missed his first best and maybe his last chance, although Keith Eric continues the pressure. Pounded on Soul Train with a big whip over to the ropes. Underneath, the train goes.
Oh, did he hit him?
Yeah. I think the locomotive just ran over Keith Eric right there. Oh, into the corner. Eric's still going. That time, Soul Train moves, snaps him down. Go for the cover. Yes, sir. He's got a count of 2 on him. And 3, and this one's over. Well, Soul Train. Boy, I tell you, the athletic ability just shows through there in the situation, doesn't it? Soul Train gets it in 59 seconds.
What a physical specimen. The winner, Soul Train Jones. We'll be back in just a moment.
Standing in the ring right now is the Hunter. The Hunter with his mascot, not his valet, not his manager, his mascot, Bambi.
He's calling for his opponent. He is just stepping into the ring right now. Out of Minneapolis, Minnesota, that is John Paul. John Paul at 226 pounds. And at 231 from Black Rock Mountain, Georgia, the Hunter. One fall, 10-minute time limit. We're underway. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
This could be a doggone good match, John, because I'm John, I'm playing Dave. Gee, after 20 years, you think I know, all of a sudden it's John. Because John Paul is a good young wrestler.
You're absolutely right.
A lot of physical ability. And speaking of physical, this Hunter, he's not very tall, but brother, is he packed in some kind of solid package, huh?
Oh, you're right. We have seen him demonstrate incredible power in the times that we have seen him. He's got the ability, he's got the moves, and he doesn't mind bending a rule either. Oh, John Paul ducks under, he presses it down to the mat, he might have it, one. Oh, one count, about one and a half is all he got. There's some of that upper body strength that the Hunter demonstrated as he threw John Paul off the top of him.
He's also got Bambi, too.
Yeah, there's Bambi, the mascot right there.
And I mentioned, not just as an idle matter of whatever, I mentioned it because her first appearance, we saw her here when Hunter got his opponent in a position. She wasn't opposed to jumping right on. Look at that. Good night. And John Paul is no flyweight by any means. Hunter caught him coming right off the ropes and dumped him over. I just caught him right in midair.
You're right. The first match we saw, Bambi actually figured in the outcome, helping the Hunter get the victory. And look, she got a high heel shoe off.
Yeah.
Look at that. Interfering. The Hunter now with a headbutt puts John Paul down to the mat. John Paul back on his feet. He's not out of it. Let me tell you, he's coming right back against this Hunter.
Hunter's going for a snap suplex, and brother, he got it. And I mean, popped him over hard. Drops with the leg down. The Hunter makes for the cover. One, and that's all.
Only a two count for him. That snap suplex again, showing you some power. John Paul is not a 150-pound kid that the Hunter is throwing around here. John Paul back in the corner. The Hunter flipped him out of there. Drops down and got him with a hand. The fist was double. Technically, that was an illegal move as he hammered him right across the chin with a doubled fist.
Yeah, the referee made him aware of it also. That doesn't mean he's going to stop it, but the referee right on top of it. John Paul on a whip, and the Hunter follows too quick. Paul out of the way.
Hunter made a mistake there that you would expect to see from a younger wrestler. Oh, reverse neck breaker. That'll snap the neck. John Paul back up in the air now. Oh, look at this Hunter. He just powered him down. Counts of two. He got him. He's able to hold on to him. 2 minutes, 53 seconds to time. The Hunter gets the victory.
Okay, the official time on it is all over. The Hunter is the winner. And right now, something that we've been looking forward to for a while, and that is getting the king on the line. We haven't talked to Jerry on the show. Jerry, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, Lance.
Okay, fine. Now we got you. Well, partner, I can tell you a lot of folks have been asking us about Jerry and how he's doing, and we thought the best thing to do would to be to get you on the phone and take a listen to the words right out of the king's mouth. How about it? Tell us how you are.
Well, Lance, to be perfectly honest, I can barely hear you. I don't know if we have a good connection or not. I don't know if you can hear me, but I can just barely hear you. I did hear you say, you know, how am I doing? I first of all want to let everybody know that as of right now, I'm doing a lot better. I feel, I feel like I'm back and ready to go. But to be perfectly honest with you, the doctors have had they set a timetable of when they thought I should start back, and they said they wanted me to wait until they think that things have healed completely. But other than that, I feel good, and I want to thank everybody for the concern and cards and letters and all of that kind of stuff. And I'm just looking forward to being back, Lance.
Okay, Jerry, I know that 99% of the folks are aware of exactly what happened in that situation with Austin Idol and Tommy Rich. But if we can, while you and I are talking, we'd like to roll the tape, which it is rolling right now. And this is after Idol and Rich have teamed up together. This was following a match where You went against Tommy Rich, and then we're going in against Idol in a single match. Rich came back in, and they double-teamed you. And, of course, there's just no way in the world any one man is going to be able to go up against both those guys at the same time, particularly with not with what they did. So that's where we are in the match right now.
Well, looking back, Lance, I realize, you know, now that that was biting off more than I could chew. At the time, I had a score I felt like to settle with both of these guys, and it wasn't a situation where I wanted a partner. It was something that I felt like I wanted to, you know, get a chance at each one of them individually, and I realized.
The folks just saw on the monitors where one on each leg, they grabbed you and slammed you into that ring post. And then slapped you around and all, and that's what the oohing, and I don't have to tell you about ooh because you were right there on the receiving end of it.
Yeah. Lance, I'm having a lot of trouble hearing you. I really having a difficulty. You know, as I said, though, I realize now that was a mistake trying to handle both of those guys, but what I'm going to do is, it's made me, you know, I've had time to sit and think about it, and I realized that there's two guys that I thought were both my friends, not only Tommy Rich, but especially Austin Idol, I thought was a close friend of mine. And I realize now that friendship and, when it comes to money, when it comes to things like titles, you're just going to have to put the friendship aside, which is what he did. So what I'm going to do, I got a personal message now. I don't know if either one of those guys are there. I realize, Lance, that I think Tuesday night there's going to be a tournament for my Southern title, right?
True. Right, that's it. Absolutely right, Jerry.
Well, this is another situation where I think that Eddie Marlin, the promoters, the championship committee, due to the injury, probably would have let me slide on that, since the last title defense was December the 28th. They probably would have let me slide until I got back. But Austin Idol, I understand, and Tommy Rich both brought this to the attention of Eddie Marlin and to the championship committee, and they said, if he can't defend the title in 30 days, the title has to be vacated, so that's why the tournament's taking place. But I got a message for both Tommy Rich and Austin Idol, and I want to just tell them this, that from now on, there's no more friendship. There's no more thoughts about friendship. They better be looking over their shoulders. They better be watching their backs from this minute. I'm talking about from right now on, because as I said earlier, I feel good. I feel like I'm well. The doctors say I need to wait a little bit longer. But that's just doctor's opinion. You know the king in the past, Lance.
Yeah.
I'm not greatest at listening to what doctors say. So I just want Austin Idol and Tommy Rich to know, you better be watching out. Look over your shoulders in the parking lots, wherever it's going to take place, brother. Because when I get close to you, I'm not going to wrestle. I'm not coming back in any matches, get in any shoulders, 1, 2, 3. I'm not worrying about any disqualifications. I'm coming to do one thing, and that's hurt those guys like they did me. And I'm talking about I'm out for good.
Well, Jerry, I'm glad to hear you say that, and I know from the tone of your voice, Idol and Rich both are talking like it was a career-ending thing, that they put you out of wrestling for the rest of your life and all of that. You obviously has clarified that, and I'm just looking forward to the time when you can be back here with us. Good luck to you, partner, and we'll see you just the first opportunity you can get back.
Thank you, Lance.
Okay, there he is, firsthand. You heard it from the king, and an opportunity to get that update, which was better than us saying it. So we're going to take time out. We still have more action coming up. We've got a match a little bit later on, expiration of time. We'll be back to it in just a second. Yowza, Wednesday night is the night. 7 big matches, Evansville Coliseum. Regular prices, including a World Heavyweight Championship match between Nick Bockwinkel and Austin Idol. There are going to be 3 title bouts in all, an International Heavyweight Championship, a Southern Tag, and the World title. Let's bring in Jeff Jarrett and Billy Travis. They'll be in there again against Big Bubba and Goliath. Well, you got by them once, but there's been some water over the dam since
that
time.
That's right. That first meeting is in the past, but now we got him again this Wednesday night. Last time we had him, Bruno came in the ring. Lance, he sort of made a habit of jumping in our matches. Today on TV, he came in, and he brought his big guys, and they brought chains. Well, let me tell you something, guys. If you want to bring chains, me and Billy will bring chains. If you want to bring bats, we'll bring bats. Wednesday night in Evansville, you got a fight on your hands.
Doesn't take much to convince you when you're with these guys. You better be ready for them, right, Billy?
You know, Lance, Jeff's been busted open. I've been busted open. Not one time, but a lot of times. It won't be the first time, won't be the last. Well, let me tell you something, you big jerks. You left us laying in the ring. You left us all bloody. Then after that, you threw that stupid cake on us. In Evansville, we're going to leave you laying, Big Bubba, and you goof Goliath. And Bruno, get in the way, brother, because we're going to leave more than cake on you. Right here's what we're going to leave on
be
you.
Be looking for that fight coming up Wednesday night right there in Evansville at the Coliseum. You're going to be seeing it along with all of the other matches. Seven in all, regular prices, and it should be some night of action. Soul Train Jones will be defending against the Hunter. You'll also be seeing the Daughter of Darkness, Locke, going against Debbie Combs. Paul Diamond against the returning Akio Sato, who is supposed to be back and healthy, and plenty of other action. Roy Lee Welch and Tarzan Goto, Alan West and Boy Tony. The Southern Tag titles will be on the line with Bubba and Goliath against Jeff and Billy, and then Nick Bockwinkel against Austin Idol. All of that Wednesday night.
All right. Expiration of time match coming up here on one side of the ring at a total weight of 526 pounds from Japan, Tarzan Goto, his partner from Arkansas, Larry Wright, and their manager, Tojo Yamamoto. Across the way, Paul Diamond in there to start the match, and his partner, Pat Tanaka. Diamond out of Thunder Bay, Ontario, Canada, Tanaka from Hawaii. Goto against Diamond.
They make a good team, Tanaka and Paul Diamond, too, Dave. They just really are very good athletes.
Well, look at Diamond. He just used a standing clothesline and put Tarzan Goto on the mat. Goto, a rugged, rugged wrestler. He's over to the corner and tags the big guy, Larry Wright. Wright weighs in at 301 pounds.
We remember Larry as a buddy of Dirty Rhodes and Don Bass, so right away that tells you the kind of company he hangs out in.
He was Torch. Fire, Flame, and Torch. And they were unmasked and were revealed to be Larry Wright.
Look at that Diamond fight his way back. Midsection with a foot, shoots a right hand, but Larry Wright muscles him with that added weight that he has. Pulling to the corner, tags Goto, and the tough former co-holder of the international tag title, Tarzan Goto, going at it hard with Paul Diamond. Pat Tanaka is yet to make an appearance in there.
They have been able to keep Paul over in their half of the ring, too, keep him away from that tag. Big right hand by Larry Wright. And a double hand across the back. Ooh. Headbutt. Vicious one, too. There's the tag from Tokyo, Japan, Tarzan Goto. Real international flavor in this match here. Two of them from Japan, Goto and Tojo. Diamond from Canada, Pat Tanaka from Hawaii, and Larry Wright from Arkansas. Larry Wright still hammering on Paul Diamond. It's been Diamond all the way for his team. He's battling back. He needs to fight his way to the corner. That's what he's trying to do. He's about a foot away from the tag, but he doesn't get it. Oh, so near and yet so far.
Pat stepped in with one foot, but he wasn't tagged, so he's not eligible to come in legally. That's for a fact. Oh, yeah! Diamond keeping his composure, and as Goto went up using the ropes, Diamond just peeled him right back, and there's a tag on Pat Tanaka.
Tanaka really cleaning house here. You know, for a minute I was afraid the referee hadn't seen the tag, but apparently he did see it out of the corner of his eye. Pat Tanaka working on Goto. Meanwhile, Wright and Paul Diamond going at each other across the ring. You got four of them going at each other. See the man in the middle of the screen? Always a factor, Tojo Yamamoto. Time is running out here. We're getting very close in this expiration of time match. When time expires, we'll have to ring the bell. The battle continues. Tanaka has just chopped Goto. There's the back kick.
What a pairing that is, Goto and Tanaka. They can both get it on.
Tanaka saying, come on back out of the corner. Come out to the middle of the ring. Goto came out there, and Pat weeds into him again.
Ooh.
Jabbed him. Goto with a chop.
I'm afraid our time is going to run out on this one, Davey. We're going to have to call it quits and get on out of here because Paul Diamond comes in with Goto, and as he nails him with that elbow, that's it. That's it. Time is up. Time is up. So that one, a good one going, and boy, there was plenty of action all the way, but it's going to end in a draw, Dave, as we run out of time, and we'll take time out here. Be back in just a moment.
Program are selected and...